often do I need to create a new emergency slash rescue slash recovery disc? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. I have a question. While I have a schedule for taking new backup images, I was just wondering if I ever have to make a new bootable flash drive. Is the bootable good forever on my specific machine? The bootable flash drive we're talking about here goes by several different names: emergency disk, rescue disk, recovery disk, and probably others. It's the drive you boot your machine from in order to perform a full restore of an image backup. Now, there are several approaches to how often you should create one, but I'll give you one huge clue on my strategy. I don't have one. Not yet. For the vast majority of backup programs, as long as you have another machine around, you can create the rescue media at the moment you need it. You don't have to have one lying around, and you don't have to worry if the one you have is the current version or not. Just run the backup software on a different machine and create the rescue media right then and there. Then you can take it to the other machine, the one you're having issues with, boot from it, and restore the image. In most cases, it doesn't even matter if you're using a free or paid version of the same software. The rescue media is often the same, or it's at least capable of performing the restore you need when you need it. Like I said, that's what I do. Now, what I've described, of course, applies to most backup software packages and to most situations. There are cases, though, where you might want to make a copy of rescue media to keep it on hand. For example, if you've got only one machine, you won't have another computer available to create a rescue disk if the one machine you have isn't working. Or the backup software you're using is very old, but clearly it still meets your needs. It's rare, but possible, that newer versions of the same tool might not support the older format created by the version you're using. In cases like these, I would make rescue media when installing the backup software for the first time. If you're already past that, well, make it as soon as you think about it. Then save it somewhere you can easily find it if and when you need it in the future. Now, there's no real hard and fast rule for updating rescue media, other than you do not need to make a new rescue media every time you back up. I would instead create rescue media under two circumstances. Your backup software goes through a major version update. For example, Macrium's update from 8 to X is a great example. They changed the backup format, and the newer backups would not be readable by the older rescue media. Or you're advised by release notes in an update to do so. Sometimes the updates to the backup software include updates to the rescue media, so a new copy might be called for. But that's about it. You don't need to spend a lot of time recreating rescue media. I honestly recommend the just-in-time method, particularly if you've got at least two or more computers. It might even be something you can rely on if you've got a friend whose computer you could use at the time. Otherwise, keep a copy, but don't worry too much about recreating it too often. More important, backup. For updates, for comments, for links related to the topic and more, visit askleo.com/179668. Remember, if you've got a question, askleo.com/ask is the place to go. If you're interested in my weekly Confident Computing newsletter, askleo.com/newsletter. And if you're interested in supporting Ask Leo and helping me do what I do, askleo.com/patron has the options. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.